لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك.
When it comes to Arafah, it's very important we realize the status of this day and the importance of this day in Islam. The Prophet ﷺ, he said that this is the most day that people will be freed from the hellfire is the day of Arafah. And so you need to, like, we always talk about this, the importance of getting into the zone. That's what the brother asked about the question, what should we be doing in Tarwiyah? This is getting into that zone. Tomorrow I'm going to Arafah, and I'm going to benefit from this time. You know, what did the Prophet ﷺ do? How did he do it? I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to focus on benefiting from this time. Best of my ability.
You've only got one shot at it.
That's it. And we have to realize the time we have there usually, the time is it's going to be from Dhuhr until Maghrib. And realize, Ya Akhwan, something very important for those who are coming for the first time, you don't really have to Maghrib. We're going to be in full Ibadah mode. The hour before Maghrib, usually your group is going to start getting ready to move to Muzdalifah.
And some will move.
And some will move.
I've seen it so many times. But you
actually have to stay. The correct opinion is you have to stay until Maghrib. You're not allowed to leave before Maghrib. But a lot of them get in the bus and get in this, so you're going to get out of that zone. So you're not going to have that opportunity really to be focusing on dua and dhikr and what have you the entire time. So it's going to be an even shorter time than what you think you have. So, and you need to get in that mindset of what you're going to do. You realize, first of all, this is the most day people will be free from the hellfire. So I have to focus in my dua on making sure that, inshallah ta'ala, I get free from the hellfire.
I mean,
the Prophet ﷺ, he said that the best dua is the dua of Arafah. And people ask about what type of dhikr and dua should we make. What is the, he said, alayhi salatu wasalam, what is the best dua that he said, me and the prophets before me used to say? La ilaha illallah, wahduhu la sharika la, wal mulku wa la alhamd, huwa ala kulli shayin qadir. Very simple dua that almost all of us know, alhamdulillah.
We say it every day.
Every day, alhamdulillah. So this is a dua that we should focus on, and a dhikr. And if you don't want to use it in your dua, use it in your dhikr. Because we say we're going to be switching it up a bit, right? Making some dua, making some dhikr. The Prophet ﷺ, what did he do during the day of Arafah when he entered? It's important to know. We talk about the practical tips. You enter into Arafah and you pray Dhuhr and Asr. When? Right away, as soon as you enter. Pray Dhuhr and Asr, Jamu Taqdeem. And you're praying Qasr, two rakats, praying right together, one after the other, and not delaying it, as soon as possible. What is the objective of this? Is to be prepared for the dua. The day of dua. Arafah is the day of dua. SubhanAllah. And we need something very important as well that many of the viewers need to know, and the brothers as well, if you didn't know, fasting the day of Arafah. What is the ajr, the reward of fasting on the day of Arafah?
For the people outside of Arafah or the people at Arafah?
Yeah.
So what are the hadith, the general hadith, what does it say in the hadith? Yeah?
For the people outside?
Outside, yeah.
Okay, for the people outside.
Expiation of sins.
Expiation,
right?
Of sins past and present for 1 year.
Yeah, past year and future year.
2 years.
And 2 years, yeah. So amazing opportunity. So somebody here's for Hajj, he said, you know what? It might be difficult, but I'm not going to miss this opportunity. I'm fasting. What do we say to this person?
Don't fast.
It's going to have this previous sins.
Yeah,
all those years.
It's already done.
It doesn't matter because now here you have another opportunity to get your sins forgiven. And we say even more reward is not to fast.
Exactly.
Why? Because the Prophet ﷺ himself didn't fast.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. And if it was better to fast, he would have fasted and would have encouraged his ummah to fast, alayhi salatu wasalam. He didn't do that. And the scholars mentioned one of the hikmahs, the wisdom behind this, is to, in order to have the strength, the quwwah, to be able to focus on the dua.
To perform
the dua of Arafah. The Prophet ﷺ, then we know what he did because we want to follow in his footsteps, alayhi salatu wasalam. He focused on making dua.
SubhanAllah.
He stayed the whole time from Dhuhr until Asr making dua. So what do you say, roughly, what is it, about 4 or 5 hours?
4 hours about, yeah.
Making dua. The only time he would stop is if somebody came to him for for iftah, to ask him about what to do. So he would answer them and then immediately turn to dua, alayhi salatu wasalam. So this is what we need to be doing. Obviously we said you can stop and make some dhikr, you can read some Quran, okay, but the majority of what we want to focus on this day is in the dua. And we want to focus on this dua being a special dua. We really feel it. Something which comes from the heart.
لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا